So the storytelling was extremely vivid, and it was deep, it was poetic, it was sophisticated, it was very fleshy and meaningful. And so I would say it's a mixture of taking that essence and mixing it with this sort of street element, you know, incorporating spray paint and oil pastels and crink and making it a little more defiant. One of my mentors, who's Shepard Fairey, he gave me some advice some years ago. He told me that my work was far too clean and too perfect, that I needed to incorporate some carelessness to it to create this tension between realism and fuck it. You know, he didn't really know exactly what that element was, but he knew that I needed to incorporate something of that nature. And my style has kind of developed into what it is today based off his advice, based off my interest in street art and Renaissance movement. The purpose of the current body of work that I'm doing now is to bridge a gap between an older generation and an older way of making art with a younger generation and a new way of making art. It's sort of a new Renaissance, if you will.
Yeah, but that's the fun part about my art and seeing it on a deck, because I already have the aesthetic of the artwork being decayed and fucked up. It already has that aesthetic. So now when the skater is skating on this and they're putting the wear and tear on the work, it becomes a collaborative project between myself and that skater, where it already looks decayed and their wear and tear on it is only going to add more to that aesthetic. So that's the cool part about my work personally, and seeing it on this type of canvas, because now it's going to become a collaborative project.